that grew and grew and turned into a Hollywood blockbuster. Actress and novelist Lynda La Plante wrote the original TV screenplays, and she's lived by one rule.
Keep the dream, because it can come to you.
She's the queen of crime novels. All of them are international bestsellers. And Widow's Revenge is the latest. She knows stage and screen and print from just about every angle. Let's welcome her to Studio 10. It's Lynda La Plante.
Thank you.
It's great to have you here. How do you dream up these very dark and compelling storylines? Where do you get them from?
It's actually, you know, I read something in the paper and I'll be fascinated by it. Then I'll dig around. You can't actually repeat the story from the paper directly, but Widows came from one article and it said this housewife, her husband had left her bankrupt. She had three children and she went to rob a post office, so was caught. And I just thought, concept of that. And then it grew and grew into Widows.
So truth is actually stranger than fiction in many cases.
What you're great at, Lynda, is creating these amazing women characters, you know, in so many of your books. And in Widows in particular, that got Steve McQueen's attention. He wanted to do a movie, and there's, you know, lauded British director Oscar winner. He wanted to make something with a lot of good, solid acting roles for chicks in it and leapt on this. Were you happy with the film version?
Yes. There were various areas, because it's very strange. He did kind of approach me and grabbed it and said, you know, how much he loved it.
Yeah.
But he also twisted it and used a lot of political, a lot of racial integrity in it, but there was, and the heart of it is the women.
Yeah, that's right.
I'd like to have seen a bit more.
Would you?
Yeah.
But it must be hard. I mean, are you ever completely satisfied with an adaptation? I guess when you do the screenplay, you are.
Yeah, I'm happy then. I'm very happy then.
Because you do have your own production company.
Yes.
And in fact, Prime Suspect, in which Dame Helen Mirren is in, that was a huge springboard for so much work and production work.
Yes.
Are you still enjoying that?
Yes, it gets harder, though. Hmm. I mean, what I find absolutely fascinating is that I've made 150 hours of TV drama.
Wow.
Wow. And you think, oh, all the experience, all the writing, that when I came to do the young Jane Tennyson, I was met with, it's hard to describe, everything I suggest, oh, I don't like that, no.
What would you know sort of thing?
Yes, it was, so I mean, my hair want to tear up.
You wanted to, you cast.
Yes,
Helen Mirren.
I always cast everything. Mm-hmm. And even when all that time ago, Helen Mirren, and they were talking about who to cast, and I said, oh, Helen Mirren. And even then, people would say, yes, has she done a lot of television? I haven't seen her in anything. And I said, she's the most incredible actress. She's but Royal Shakespeare Company.
But you two did have somewhat of a turbulent relationship.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What was going on there?
Well, I had in my left hand a real policewoman who guided me through autopsies, incidents, everything. Her fingerprints were all over every script. And what she said, I obeyed, really. And when I first met Helen and saw a few rushes, I called her over and I said, there's just a little bit you have to know. Don't smile so much. Don't touch. Because she was so used to being a very tactile actress. When she became the policewoman, she was automatically saying, oh, John, could you? And I said, no, 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 you can't do that. Also, don't shout. Just, and don't, funnily enough, fold your arms.
How big did the blow-ups get between you two?
Oh, very little.
do you get on today? Do you still get on?
Yes, I could not.
Because I love that series. I mean, she's a Prime Suspect. I could watch it again and again. In fact, I do.
I do too.
because she was one of the really first great gritty female roles on TV, wasn't she, in that sort of era? Do you think the Me Too movement's kind of catching up with you now, with what you were doing?
It's about time. truthfully.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I've honestly had very little ever. You know, sometimes I go, nobody's ever come on to me. But the reality is, you know, you've got to say, where are the agents that look after these young actresses?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I think so many young actors and actresses are now asked to do virtually, I think, porno films. Mm-hmm. You know, they're naked, and it's some agents got to say, excuse me, no. She's 17, I won't allow that. Mm. And I think that part of the industry has been very lacking. So the naive girl really pays a price.
And a female screenwriter isn't going to put that scene in, are they, generally speaking?
But, you know, even though I will stipulate in the script a body on, you know, for an autopsy...
Yep.
I will always say you don't need to see it absolutely naked. Mm. The sheet can cover it. You get just as much emotion from somebody saying, yes, that is my daughter. You don't have to have the nudity.
Mm. It's the power of suggestion, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
We could talk to you all day. You are fantastic. Lynda's book is out now. It's called Widow's Revenge. Please put your hands together for the one.
Great to see you.
The only one. Lynda, thank you.